Perth, the Premier says police actions at the protest were justified and that they'll stay at the site for as long as needed despite the high cost.
A day after police clashed with protesters, the Premier was defending their actions, maintaining officers are likely to be there for some time.
If it's required to keep the road usable, then I imagine the police will stay. Look, people are not entitled.
Mr Barnett concedes it's a costly exercise, but says Woodside isn't contributing.
This is a government which is judging footy followers and concert goers for policing. If they're going to apply that rule to footy fans, they should apply it to Woodside as well.
Colin Barnett was also feeling the heat.
The government hasn't got the approvals for the site. How can we dance when?
Next year's
Premier,
I feel so ashamed.
How could it be seen as being self-determination with the threat of compulsory acquisition looming over their head?
But he had the backing of the former Labor Premier, Peter Dowding. Mr Dowding was involved in the 1980 Nookanbart dispute and says this situation is far different.
The traditional owners went through a process and reached an agreement by majority.
The Federal Environment Minister, Tony Burke, has met groups for and against the project and says he's not decided whether to give it environmental approval. The Premier isn't concerned.
No, look, I don't know what you mean by federal environmental approval. There's an environmental act relating to biodiversity. This site has been selected because it doesn't have a biodiversity.
Because it means more to us than any dollar, it means more to us than any mineral, anything that you can rip out of this earth. It belongs in the earth, it belongs in this ground, and it's our duty as human beings to make sure that everything stays intact, to make sure that everything is preserved for everybody, not just Indigenous people, but everybody around the world.
Australian people and the government of this country have forgotten where each other stands. The government of this country is actually employed by the people of this country to be the administrative arm of the people. They have failed in that duty of care. The government has the power that we the people entrusted them. They are currently operating in breach of trust. They should be required to show cause why the entire Australian government and every politician who supports gas mining should not be held for breach of trust and taken to the Hague and prosecuted for environmental crimes. We need to realise the position the government holds, and that is as the administrative arm of the people and nothing more. It is useless to try to use the system to bring down the system, because the system itself is so corrupt that it would create this situation to begin with. We need to take this matter in hand, and I see gas mining as a wonderful opportunity to bring the people together. And I'm reminded of a quote by the Senator who said that it's not that it's difficult that we don't dare, it's that we don't dare that makes it difficult. So let's dare to be the custodians of this planet that we are, and let's stand up and address this issue right now.